She's injured. She can still do it.
Sagas! Jazz!
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
Valravn.
Valravn's song. It's over here. It's over here.
Is that? It's over there. No, it's here. There's two.
Listen, focus, listen.
It's magic. It's magic. It's magic. She's been in the forest like this before.
This reminds me of somewhere. The forest.
Where? Which forest?
The forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She left the wild.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But it didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Open it.
She has to.
Not from this side.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.
The ravens.
The ravens.
They've gone.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some are still there.
But where? Some are still there.
The poor raven's helping.
No. He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet. Sorry. I can't think.
Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods.
Where?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
Where have they gone?
Where have they gone?
She did it. What does it mean?
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And in the gloom, the smallest hints of shape, sound, or thought grew in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws.